Hello guys, welcome back to my channel VFX Expert. So guys, in this today's class we are going to see relighting in new. So here we will do relighting using normal pass and position pass inside new. So first we will render our all these AOBs from Maya, then we will do relighting inside Nuke. So let's start the class here. So now guys, we are inside Maya here. So here simple, this is our basic 3D scene here. So this is our main objects or character here, and this is our background here, and this is our camera here, and these are our lights. So mainly just I have used 3-point light setup for lighting our scene here. So now just we have to select panels, and just we have to select over this camera here. So now we are looking through this camera here, and this is our main scene here, which is just I am looking through over this main camera here. Now we have to render our scene. So because here I have used these Arnold light, so just we have to render our scene using Arnold renderer here. So simply just we have to click on this Arnold, then click on render. So now here Arnold is just rendering our scene here. And this is our main scene here. So you can see it's rendering here. Even if you want to check these lights effect, then simply you can select any light here. So maybe suppose this light 2, then in this attribute, if you want, you can just change this intensity. So if you want to make it just 0, so you can see this affecting here. Now just again press Ctrl Z here, and mainly just I have used 3-point light setup for lighting our scene here. So now after this, we have to render our this scene, and also we have to render some AOBs for relighting scene inside Nuke here. So mainly for relighting our scene, we need 2 passes. First, position pass. Second, normal pass. So for assigning our AOBs, we have to click on this settings. Then render using Arnold. Then we have to click on this AOBs. Now we have to assign about 2 main important AOBs, which is mainly required for relighting scene inside new. First, this normal pass. Second, this position pass. Even if you want, you can also assign this RGBA. By default, this will also render your beauty pass or RGBA pass. Okay. So again, just we have to render about this scene. So just click here. And if you want to check your each passes, then simply we can select this normal pass. So this is a normal pass here. And this is our positions pass here. Now again, just select this beauty pass here. Even if you want, you can just only render your object without this background. Okay. So this is totally depends on your requirements. So but here just I am going to render about this main scene with this background here. Now minimize this one. Then again, we have to click on this settings here. Then we have to click on this common. Then inside, then in image format, we have to select this EXR. And also we have to enable over this merge AOB. This again important things here. So this will just create a multi-pass layer here. Then in frame or animation, so suppose if you have created any animation, maybe for character or camera, then we have to select here this name.h.exe. This one we have to select if you have created animation here, because here I'm going to render a single frame. So then only we have to select this single frame here. Then here downside. In camera, we have to select our main camera, whichever this camera one here, you can see. Then presets, here I have selected this full HD 1920x1080, because here just I have set over this camera according to over this 1920 frame size here. Okay, now finally we have to close this render settings window here. Then we have to click on this drop down here, and just we have to select this rendering. Then in render menu, just we have to click on this batch render here. So now here downside you can see. So now here rendering has started. Then after this, you have to check your Maya project folder. So if you have defined your Maya project, then you have to check your defined project. Otherwise, by default, this will save in documents in Maya project. Okay. So now here rendering has completed. Then after this, we have to also export our scene camera. This is again the most important things here. So now we have to select over this main camera or scene camera. Then we have to click on file, then export selections. Then we have to select our folder or location. So inside this scene folder, just simple give a name. Then in FBX format, we have to export our camera. Okay, so here I've selected this FBX. Now we have to click on export selections here. Now just we have to open our Nuke. So now we are inside Nuke here. So first we have to import our rendered file here. Then we have to click on image, then select this read node and just select to render file here. So here inside my Maya project, so inside this images folder, this is our rendered file. We just type render from Maya. So simply just we have to select and just we have to click on open here. Now just view this file. So you can see, so this is our rendered file. We just type render from Maya. And also this is a multipass EXR. So if you want to check your normal pass or position pass, then simple in this layer option you can check. So this is your normal pass and this is your position pass. So finally, again, we have to select this RGBA. This is again important things here. Even if you want to shuffle your position pass, normal pass from this layer, then simply you can use shuffle load. So again, press tab and just take a shuffle load. Simply you can connect, then double click here. Then in this RGBA, we can select over this normal and just we can define normal pass. Now just we have to connect all these. We have to drag and drop this input into over this output layer here. So this is our normal pass here. Then same control C, control V, paste, connect it here, double click here. Then this is our position pass. So then inside this, we can select these positions. Now just select this one, press 1. So like this, you can also shuffle your normal pass and position pass from this multipass EXR. So if there is any requirement, then simply you can shuffle your all these passes here. Now just delete all these shuffle nodes. So now after this, just I'm going to start procedure of relighting for our this scene here. So for relighting our scene, we need a position to point node. So press tab, you can type position to point node. This is available in this geometry category. In this geometry category, this is position to point node. Then simply we can connect it here. Then here in right side, in our this surface normal, we have to define our normal pass. And inside this surface point, we have to define our point position pass or position pass here. So simply just we can select over this position pass. So now here, if you will see, this is our actually 3D representation of our this scene. So you can see here, see this is our main character and this is our background here. Then after this, we have to take a scene. Then simply we can take a scene node. Then just connect it here. Then take a light and just connect it here with our this scene. Now with the help of this light, simply we can relight our scene. So simply double click on this light. Then we can move according to your requirement. So you can see here. So you can see like this. So then after this, what we have to do, because just we have to relight our this main scene. So for relighting our scene, we have to take a relight node. So this is actually our 3D setup. So with the help of this, simply we can view over this 3D setups and just we can adjust our light positions here. But for relighting our scene, we need a relight node. So again, press tab and take a relight node. So again, this is available in this light category. So inside this, you will get this relight node here. Then in this relight node, you will get two input, first light, then second color. So this color input we have to connect with our this main render file, whichever this EXR file. So just here we have to connect, and this light input we have to connect over this light. Now just simply we can connect it here. Now here you will get another input, whichever actually camera input. So for camera, first we have to create a camera for our scene. Then we have to import our main 3D camera. We just type exported from Maya. This is again most important things here. So just double click on this camera. Then here in file, click on this read from file. Then we have to click and just select your camera which you have exported from Maya. So this is our main camera. We just type exported from Maya. Simply we have to select and we have to click on open here. Then we have to click on yes. So now here just type imported our main scene camera. We just type exported from Maya. So you can see, then simply we have to connect it here. Then we will get another input, which is our this material input. So for this material, we have to take a Phong node. So if you want, you can just click on the 3D option. Then inside shaders, we can take a fog material here. So simply this one. Even you can also press tab and just you can type fog. And you can also take from here. Okay, now to delete this one here. So simple, with this material input, we have to connect over with this fog material here. Now we have to select this relight node and press 1. Now press tab here. So nothing we are getting here. So finally, what we have to do, just simply we have to double click on this relight node. Then inside this normal pass, we have to define a normal pass. So simply just click in the drop down and just select this normal. And also point position pass, we have to select over this point positions pass here. Now we are getting here this light. So you can see which just I created with the help of this light. And if you want to adjust your light position, all these things, then simply you can view your this scene and just you can adjust your light position. So just double click on this light. You can see here these positions. So now simply just we can move over this light. So simply we can see here this effect. This light effect. Now again just select this one, press 1, relight node, press tab. So simply we can see here. Then after this, we can simply double click on this fog node. So here, if you want to use only specular or highlights, then simply we can make this diffuse value 0. So just make it 0. So only just we are getting these highlights or speculars here. Even you can also adjust this specular. Then finally, what we have to do? Then finally, we have to take a merge node. So again, just take a merge node, press M. And in this B input, we have to connect over this original render file. So just connect it here. Then in A input, we have to connect over this relight output here. Now select this merge node, press 1. Then simply double click here. Then in operations, we have to select this plus. So now this is our actually final relight output here. Now just define properties 1, so easily we can understand all these things here. So you can see here, so this is our original sort, and this is after relighting. So you can see here, and here suppose if you want to control maybe this specular, then you can simply double click in this fog, then you can adjust this specular value if you want to adjust. So you can see these speculars, even diffuse also. This is totally depends on your requirement, but here just I make this diffuse value 0. Even if you want to suppose adjust lighting color, all these things, then simply we can double click on this light node. Then we can also adjust this light intensity. So you can also see here this one. So by default, just make it 1 here. Even if you want to change color, then simply we can also change color. So you can see. Now again, select this scene. So you can see here this light effect. And now suppose if you want to use another light, suppose if you want to relight scene from our this back area, so how we can use multiple lights here. So for using multiple lights, simply what we can do, we can use another scene node and just we can combine our multiple lights here. So here just I'm going to show you here how we can combine. So again, just take a scene node. So this is our first light. So what we have to do, simply just we have to connect with this, then take another light and just we can connect another light with this scene. Then finally, because in this relay node only one light input here, so what we can do, just simply we can connect this input with our this scene. So now we can actually use these two lights and just we can adjust over this scene. Now again, just place your light here and just also connect with this main scene here. So we can also see inside this. So just double click on this light 2. So this is our actually another light, which will be our this actually just like a rim light. So you can see this second light. So simply just we can adjust it here. You can see here this is affecting here. And if you want to check inside output, then again you can select this main output node and press 1 here. So simply we can see. Now if you want to adjust intensity, second light. So this is our second light. So simply we can adjust this intensity. So you can see this is just affecting this back side here. So you can see. So like this, just you can use multiple lights and just you can adjust your light positions and just you can relight your scene. So guys, this is our actually main final relighting output here. So we can see, and this is our main rendered scene and this is our final relight scene. And remaining thing, just you can adjust according to your requirements here. Even guys, if you have animated scene, then you can also do relighting using same technique. So here this is our actually, I have animated some frame for this scene. So you can see here. So you can also do relighting with same techniques here. So guys, till here I have completed over this class, relighting using normal pass and position pass inside Nuke. So if you like this video, please watch, share, comment and subscribe my channel if you are still not subscribed my channel. So thanks for watching.